Apple Intelligence was released on October 28th, 2024, and was met with a very critical response.
You have to be an idiot to like Apple Intelligence.
They promised so much, and yet...
it doesn't feel very intelligent.
A lot of this hatred was really towards user experience, but the actual AI model behind Apple Intelligence has a lot of redeeming qualities. In particular, it's really impressive for a local model. Usually, using an AI requires sending your data to a server with lots of expensive GPUs, where the actual computation happens, and then getting back the response. But the basic model of Apple Intelligence runs locally on your computer, or even an iPhone. Being a local model does mean that it's generally less powerful, but it is great for both speed and privacy. Your data never has to leave your device, taking time in transit to go off to some potentially mischievous company. And because the model runs locally, Apple can make it completely free for users and developers. But of course, there's a catch. It's locked to running on Apple devices with Apple Silicon, and you can only access the models using Apple's foundation model framework in Swift. This is unfortunate if, say, you only have one Apple device but want to access the model from somewhere else. Or you want to use the foundation models but your app isn't written in Swift. Or even if you're running a site that tries to offer users access to as many AI models as possible. For example, consider an SEO platform like Profound. They track the sentiment of different AI models towards different businesses. It would be cool to offer customers data on the model behind Siri, but there's no way to do this without integrating Swift into your tech stack. So, how can we get around these restrictions? I can think of two solutions. One would be reverse engineering. If we could find the model weights and hyperparameters, we would literally be able to run it on whatever device we want. But I can't imagine Apple making this easy for us, so I didn't really give this much thought. An easier solution would be to create a web server that runs on an Apple Intelligence-enabled device. Then, when other devices send requests to the server, the Apple device will process it with the foundation model and send back the response, working just like a regular LLM API. Doing this, we might lose some of the upsides that come with having a local model, but it's not actually too bad. First of all, if you're running it for yourself, you can keep everything on your local network, which is still fast, and you won't be foregoing privacy. And second of all, if you were making a proper service out of this, you would have latency, but you would be gaining access to a model that you otherwise wouldn't have access to. So I think it's an acceptable trade-off. Now that we've talked about what we're going to build, we just have to go and do it. Writing this in Swift was the obvious choice, since that's what the foundation model framework is given in. I started by playing around with the foundation model framework, reading the docs, seeing how it worked, and seeing what was possible. The framework has a lot of cool features, including streaming responses, guided generation, and tool calling. After I felt confident with that, I moved on to trying to make the web server. I was prepared to write one from scratch, but Swift actually has some nice frameworks for this. I went with Vapor, but Hummingbird looked like a great option too. Once I was comfortable with both pieces, the web server and the foundation models framework, I just had to connect them. The key decision here was what the API should look like from the user's perspective. I had two options. I could mimic the foundation model's API directly, or follow an existing web standard like OpenRouter, which itself is based on OpenAI's API. I went with the second option because it makes my server a drop-in replacement. Users can switch from using OpenAI or OpenRouter to using my API just by changing the URL in their code. The implementation was pretty straightforward at this point. It's basically a four-step process. Parse an incoming request, create a foundation model session, get the response from the large language model, and then send it back following the right standard. Now that it's working, we gotta actually use it. To test my API, I wanted to build a simple web app that uses OpenRouter, and then see if I could just change the URL to get it to work with Apple Intelligence. And now to check if it's really working, I should be able to call the API from my Windows computer when I'm on the website. Okay, so here is the Apple Intelligence server. I just need to start running this. And so now if I change the URL and the model, and now I'm gonna switch over to my PC. So now I just need to load up the site, and it works. Awesome. I also wanted to stress test the server running on my MacBook Air. I wrote a Python script that spammed it with concurrent requests to see where performance degraded. My M2 MacBook Air could handle about 10 concurrent requests while maintaining an average 20 tokens per second. This is probably the minimum throughput you'd want for a passable user experience. And so that's perfectly fine for personal use or for a small team, but probably not good enough for a public service. This isn't too surprising given that it's running on a single MacBook Air, with plenty of space for horizontal and vertical scaling. And in general, there's still plenty of room for improvement, which is great news if you're looking to contribute to an open source project. Right now, there's no authentication or rate limiting, which you would definitely want before exposing this beyond your local network. there are also some features we could add. Two big ones are structured outputs and tool calling. These are both things that the foundation models are capable of, but that I haven't implemented in the API yet. This project is actually split across three GitHub repositories. There's the main API, the load tester, and that minimal chat interface. All three have open issues with plenty of low-hanging fruit if you want to get your hands dirty. Now for the big question. Can I make any money off of this?
Gotta figure out how to make money on this thing. It's simply too good.
My thinking is maybe, but probably not. It really comes down to whether or not anyone would pay for access to this model. For now, this is best suited for the use cases I mentioned at the start. Running your own server at home to access Apple intelligence from any device or application, bridging the foundation models to other programming languages so that you can build apps in Python or JavaScript instead of Swift, or integrating Apple's models into platforms that aggregate multiple AI providers, like those SEO tools tracking brand sentiment across different models.